Most whistleblower cases come from a corporate executive or an insider, not this one.
It was a patient looking at a bill, getting medication he knew he didn't ask for, and actually having the courage to do something about it.
The slip and fall patient complained he received two shipments of pain meds and scar cream.
And on the third delivery, actually called the company, said, stop sending these things to me. And instead of just saying, okay, they pushed back on him. So he did something about it.
The feds maintain Age Vital's owners receive Medicare payments of more than $37,000 for meds the patient didn't need or want.
They made a killing sending these unsolicited medications to Medicare and Medicaid patients. It was a company built purely on a profit model. They weren't trying to help patients.
Age Vital owner Dr. Jenny Wilkins is a well-known member of the community who has appeared on Channel 8's daytime program. She tells me she agreed to the more than $750,000 at the advice of her attorney, who warned the feds could go after much more.
This attack is a perfect example of the politics involved with big government, the insurance companies, and jealous big pharmaceutical companies wanting to eliminate the private pharmacy sector.
Dr. Wilkins insists no laws were broken.
Did you pay a kickback to a third party to get his information?
Nope. No kickbacks from third parties, nothing.
Lawyer Jesse Hoyer says the case started with a patient that believed the taxpayers were being cheated.
You have the power to stop this fraud.
Age Vital's owner maintains this case should have been between the patient and the doctor, not the pharmacy. Pinellas County, Peter Bernard, News Channel 8.